Think about what you had for dinner last night. Did you happen to eat any vegetables? Well, even if you didn't, almost everything you eat comes from a plant. That includes fruits, nuts, flour, beans, and grains. Even sugar comes from a plant. Animals also eat plants to grow, so even eating things that come from animals, like meat, fish, or dairy, requires plants. Plants are super important for our health, and without them we would all be very, very hungry.
I'm Elliot Meyerowitz. I'm a professor at the California Institute of Technology, and I study how plants grow. For me, the most fascinating thing about plants is how little we know about them. There's so much to learn.
Plants grow very differently from humans. Humans are born with everything they need.
We won't get extra fingers or extra legs or extra anything after we're born, and so we just get bigger in all directions from all parts of ourselves. But plants do most of their growth after they're born.
Plants can grow from a really tiny seed into a huge tree. Wow!
So you get growth in three dimensions, up, down, and out.
Plants grow down through their roots, up through shoots and branches, and out by their trunks and stems getting thicker. Elliot tries to understand how plants grow by studying their genes. Genes are tiny molecules that store information. Every living thing has genes in their cells. The genes that are in plants decide things like how tall the plants will be and how much water and sunlight it needs to grow. Elliot studies plants by adding new genes to plants or by taking genes away from a plant. After he has successfully added or taken a gene away, he can see what happens to the plant. It might grow shorter or have less flowers. It might need less water or more sunlight to grow. And since he has to wait for the plants to grow, these experiments take a long time. Figuring out what genes do in a plant is not that easy. Sometimes genes do more than one thing, and sometimes one gene relies on another gene in order to do its job.
If we alter the function of multiple genes, it's very hard in our heads to predict what that will do to the plant, even if we know the function of each individual gene, because the genes interact with each other and their products interact with each other.
By understanding what genes do in a plant, Elliot can change them so that the plant grows bigger and better.
The big goal of our research is to understand better how plants grow so that farmers can use less fertilizer, less water, and less land to produce the amount of food that we need for a growing population.
There's plenty of reasons for us to want to improve crops we use for food.
The one big problem the plant scientists can solve is how to grow crops efficiently and sustainably in a changing climate. Because if we can't figure this out, a lot of people will go hungry.
Want to design your own genes to make a mechanical plant grow? Check out the activity on Curiosity Machine.